We're going to call the May 6, 2019 Public Works Committee meeting to order with roll call.
Mr. Gattura?
Here.
Mrs. Meany?
Here.
Mr. Schimmets?
Here.
Okay, that's going to take us to changes to the agenda, which we have none. We have two sets of minutes.
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes of April 1st, 2019.
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Gattura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schimmets?
Yes. And I'll make a motion to approve the minutes of April 15th, 2019.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Gattura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schimmets?
Yes.
It'll take us to pending. We have none. So that brings us to our new section, item number one, the storm response status update. Mr. Gilardi is here this evening. Looks like he has some visual aids for us. Woo-hoo. How are you doing, Mike?
Hello, how are the committee tonight? How is everybody tonight?
Very well. The sun is shining.
Always a bonus.
For how long?
Well, we hope. You know, it's Ohio. It could change with the minutes. So for April 2019, we had 3.33 inches of rainfall. Last month was 2.52, so we are on the upswing with the April flowers, bring May flowers thing. So we're right where we should be. This month, our TV truck completed the TV inspections of multiple locations for the 2019 concrete replacement program for engineering. We didn't really find anything major. Our annual inspection of our city-owned detention retention ponds has been completed. We have the HOA and the ILO to go. And our storm truck assisted our sanitary truck with cleaning the Nestle line. It works out better. The storm truck actually provides water. It's a little bit more streamlined process to get that done a little bit more quicker. And I'd like to update the committee that Trax is in full swing. That's our storm and sanitary contractor. They completed the job on Springside, which was to run a new storm lateral across the road into an existing catch basin. They completed a catch basin install over here on Somm. And they also completed a sanitary lateral repair across the road on Sullen Road over at True North. And currently they're working down at our northeast lift station, and they are doing a retaining wall. And I have some pictures for the committee. Do they have any questions before I pictures? Okay. Document camera, please. Okay, so what you're looking at is the northeast lift station, which is at the bottom of Deer Run. And what you're looking is there is they took out the existing concrete. It was just concrete slabs, and over time it started to erode, and they were starting to lose a lot of the property. It was getting close to a chain link fence. So Trax came in and they excavated, removed all the concrete. What you're looking at there, it's approximately 130 feet and it's going to be about 8 foot deep. And what they did was they removed all that, and what you see here is erosion screening, and there's some stone here, and they're starting to build up the bank. And then what they did was they brought in a product called Armor Stone. These are 5 to 7 ton stones. They're as big as a Volkswagen or a Kia, and they set those down first and they build from that. So it's all going to be a solid stone retention wall, and it should last for years to come. So they're doing a really good job. Probably be done hopefully this week sometime. Any questions? Okay, thank you.
Thanks, Mike.
That's going to bring us to item number two, the City of Solon 2019 Infrastructure Improvements Report. With that, we'll have Engineer Bush. Hi, John.
Good evening. How's the committee?
Oh, thank you. Got a couple of new items on there. A
couple items, yes. To update the committee from last month, we, under our Priority 1 projects, we awarded the Arbordale Avenue reconstruction project, as well as the Nestle traffic signal on Bainbridge Road. Moving down into our Priority 2 projects, we had some expenditures under our emergency and miscellaneous roadway repair project. And then moving down into our Priority 3s, we had some updates to our engineering chargebacks, as well as our traffic signal repair program. If there's any questions from the committee, I can address those now.
I guess that'll bring us to item number three, the 2019 annual preventative maintenance program contract. We have a bid tabulation.
Yes, on April 22nd, the City of Solon opened bids for our 2019 preventative maintenance program. Two bids were received. The apparent low bidder was Asphalt Fabrics and Specialties in the amount of $98,790. The bid tabulation, which has been checked by the Finance Committee, is attached for the committee's consideration. The engineer's estimate for this project was $150,000. We did not check their references. As I noted in my memo, they've done this project for the City of Solon several years in the past. I have also provided to the committee kind of a history of their unit cost there, so you can kind of compare the unit cost that we've awarded in the past versus this year. This year, the total unit cost was 42 cents versus just looking at last year even was 57 cents. So it's a lot less than we awarded last year. So I am recommending that this project be awarded to Asphalt Fabric and Specialties under emergency so that we can start the project as soon as possible in the amount of $98,790.
Any questions?
That came in well under. That's nice.
Okay, I'll go ahead then and make a motion to have legislation prepared awarding the 2019 annual preventative maintenance program to Asphalt Fabrics and Specialties in the amount of $98,790. And this is to be done under emergency so that they can start the construction as soon as possible.
We have a motion.
Second.
Okay, motion and a second. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmets?
Yes.
The sunshine.
Takes us to item number four, the 2019 Fire Hydrant Painting Program contract. This is a bid tabulation.
Yes, on April 22nd, the City of Solon opened bids for our 2019 Fire Hydrant Painting Program. This is kind of as a follow-up to the presentation that Mr. Gilardi gave to the committee on our plan to repaint all the hydrants in the city. This project will paint all of the hydrants west of Soms, including Soms Center to the west, including Country View Estates. The balance of the hydrants will be repainted under a program next year. We did open those bids, as I mentioned, on April 22nd. The apparent low bidder was Athos Contracting in the amount of $183,701. The engineer's estimate was $175,000. We did check their references, which I provided to the committee in my memo. In addition to checking their references, Athos Contracting has done work on behalf of the City of Solon. The most recent project they did was they repainted the City Hall parking lot lights here at City Hall last summer. So we are very familiar with their work, and based on their references and our previous working experience with them, I'm recommending that this project be awarded to Athos Contracting in the amount of $183,701 under emergency in order to start the work as soon as possible.
Mrs. Meany?
I just really have a comment. I mean, I'm so happy to see this. Probably since I've been on council, one of the complaints I get are how bad some of the fire hydrants look. So I think this is, I know we've tried other methods,
yes,
of doing this, so I'm just happy to see that you know, we're going to have a company that I think is going to do it right, as they say, not to criticize anybody, but you know, so like I say, I'm just really happy that this is going to be happening.
I concur. All right, I'd like to make a motion to have legislation prepared to accept the bid of Athos Contracting for the 2019 Fire Hydrant Painting Program, contract number 2019.15, in the amount of $183,701, and have that done under emergency in order to start the project as soon as possible.
And I'll second that.
Motion and a second. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmets?
Yes. Takes us to item number five, the Miles Road Retaining Wall Replacement Project.
Yes. In preparation for some projects for 2020, I'm proposing to the committee to use Burgess and Nyepel to remove and replace the retaining wall at the intersection of Somme and Miles intersection. As you can see from these photos, this is one of them. You can see the extensive deterioration, most likely from the salt. This retaining wall probably sits less than 10 feet from the edge of the road. In addition to the salt deterioration, in most of the locations where these posts are installed, they were drilled into the retaining wall stone themselves, and you can see here cracks. These are very evident, but just about every location where that post was cored into that block, there's a crack. Some are very hairline, and some are more noticeable like that. This wall was installed as part of the intersection improvement project that the city did with the village of Moreland Hills in the early 2000s. So this wall is about 20 years old. May have lasted a little longer had it been sealed appropriately when it was in its infancy. Unfortunately, I don't think it was, which caused a lot of the deterioration. But I am proposing to the committee to use the services of Burgess and Nyepel, who is currently our engineering consultant through our general engineering services contract, to prepare plans and specifications to replace this wall as part of our 2020 infrastructure program in the amount of $59,850. A breakdown of their scope and fee is attached for the committee's consideration.
Mrs. Meany?
John, how much do you think, I mean, off the top of your head, something like this is going to cost us?
We're gonna try to make it match what we did to the retaining wall mm-hmm. facing here. So it's gonna be a little bit more aesthetic than mm-hmm. kind of more just like this. So right. It's probably gonna be $200,000 or $300,000, I'm guessing, by the time we're all done, because we'll build a basic retaining wall and then face it with either thin brick or full brick mm-hmm. with a concrete masonry cap, and then this fence, galvanized fence, will replace with the black aluminum. So it'll look a lot like what we did here on the Somme Center retaining wall here at the bridge.
John, what year did you say?
It was early 2000s. I think it was like either 2000 or 2001. I remember it was a joint project that the city did with the village of Moreland Hills to expand the intersection, widen the intersection.
Okay, I'll go ahead then and make a motion to have legislation prepared authorizing the engineering department to proceed with the design of the Miles Road retaining wall replacement project. And this would be Burgess and Nyepel, and in an amount not to exceed $59,850.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schimmitz?
Yes.
Takes us to item number 6, the Aurora Road reconstruction contract.
Yes.
That's an amendment.
The engineering department is requesting amendment to the original consulting services for GPD for the phase one construction. When the original contract for the design services was awarded to GPD, there was a few things that they had noted in their proposal based on the fact that they were unknowns at the time because we didn't have ODOT's input. And I noted those in the attached original contract scope on page 7. One was the environmental requirements that ODOT was going to require. And secondly, the second one was the right-of-way plans, because we didn't know what the alignment of the road was ultimately going to be at the time we did the initial design. So we didn't know really the number of parcels that would be impacted as far as permanent and temporary takes. So now that we have had our scoping meetings with ODOT to finalize everything and we finalized the alignment, we can move forward with those two work items, which the Environmental Services is in the amount of $16,788, and the right-of-way plans are in the amount of $95,278 for a total of $112,066. These are all based on hourly rates that have been set and established through our traffic engineering services contract with GPD.
Mrs. Meany?
Sir John, does this add to the already amount that we let, you know, pass legislation?
Yes. Yes, it does.
Does that seem like, seems like a lot of money? So now we're up
The environmental services doesn't seem like a lot. Unfortunately, one thing that happens when you obtain federal ODOT money is that you have to abide by a lot of their additional federal ODOT requirements. And with this project being on Aurora Road, which is a state route, we have to do the ODOT right-of-way plans in accordance with their requirements, which are pretty detailed. And that's why you'll see that fee is a lot.
Okay.
But from your perspective, it wasn't unexpected.
No. No.
We knew it was coming. We just didn't have all the details in order to be able to include that.
And their fee for these right-of-way plans also, as noted in their scope, it also includes them coming back after the work is done and restaking and repinning the right-of-way areas that we take, because that'll reestablish the persons, the property that takes properties based on our right-of-way take. So we'll repin the properties accordingly, and that's included in this fee.
Anything further from the board?
All right, I'd like to make a motion authorizing the mayor and engineering department to proceed with the requested design amendment for the Aurora Road reconstruction project in the amount not to exceed $112,066 with GPD Group for traffic engineering services.
And I'll second that.
Motion and a second. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmicks?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thanks, John. It's going to take us to item number 7, the SOM Center Aurora Intersection Improvement Project, change order number 1. With that, we're going to have Mr. Dursick.
Good evening.
Hey, Bill. How are you?
Good. How is the committee this evening?
Very well.
Wonderful. As I stated in the April 22nd special council meeting, I gave an update to the council on how the project was going for 4391 improvements. I had stated in that council meeting that there was going to be a change order coming up. The change order was required because we had to take the sanitary sewer main and move it into the street based on a conflict with the East Ohio Gas line that was in the original plans in the tree line. So with that being said, requesting the council approve a change order in the amount of $258,781. $191,571 of these dollars is for the, since we were in the road, we have to reconstruct the road, put a new base in. The items and the dollar amounts that are a part of this figure are already fixed units that are in the contract already. CATS has agreed to use those units. So those are the units that we agreed on for that dollar amount. Additional work is to redo the curb on the north side of the road, 1,300 linear feet, using type 6 curb, which is the straight up and down curb. In addition to that, since we are putting new curb in and new road base on the south side, John requested that we put in new under drain to make sure that we don't have any issues with frost. So the engineering department's requesting a change order for a total amount of change order number 1, the amount of $258,781 to perform the work described above under emergency so we can coordinate this work to complete the balance of the project. The current contract amount is $6,581,647.37. This change order would bring the revised contract amount to $6,840,428.37. I could entertain any questions the committee has.
Well, one of my first questions was, what is type 6 curb? But you've answered that. So,
it's basically you have the road here and the curb is kind of separate to the road.
But it's not tapered.
No, it's straight up and down.
Straight up and down.
With a 5 to 6 inch reveal after the asphalt is put on.
How long of a section is the conflict? And so we're going to be redoing the road and everything?
I believe it was, Dan, correct me if I'm wrong, it's around 1,000 feet.
Substantial amount. The number sounds like a big number. But I think when you really look at everything that's involved, and we look at some of these other, when we do these reconstruction projects and road replacement projects, I was impressed with the ability of your department to, as well as the contractor, to be able to pivot and to keep this thing moving forward. The only other option would have been to move the gas line, correct?
Gas line, or there's a whole constructability issue with them basically fighting with the gas line the whole way and trying to, you know, maintain the gas service without any issues and
would
putting
it would be expense to us and them relocating the gas line?
If they relocate the gas line, yes.
So,
what that number is, I have no idea.
Right. The idea is, though, that there was going to be a change order no matter what, and there was going to be additional cost. So, does anybody have anything else, Dave?
I mean, I guess just a comment. I mean, I don't like change orders, but I know, especially a project this big, that once you get underground and see things that maybe you thought you could do and you end up not being able to. So, I mean, I'm really understanding of, you know, this happening. I hope we don't see any more because it's, you know, obviously a very expensive project. But I do understand that, you know, sometimes things happen. And I agree with you, to try to mess around with the gas line, then you get the possibility that, you know, there's a lot of businesses on Aurora Road there, you know, plus some residential. Well, I guess there's not residential. But, you know, you wouldn't want to see that be affected.
Right. And just so the committee is aware, the unit amounts that are in the contract are the unit amounts we're using to install the sewer, and that also includes all the restoration behind the curb. So that's the sidewalks and the new aprons and any landscaping that goes along with it. This change order only is the restoration of the road piece, which basically you have to replace that whole lane because you don't want to have a 2-foot piece of curb and road sitting out there all by itself. So.
And I am in complete agreement with the engineer. I think now is the time to change the under drain. John, did you have anything?
I just was going to add to what Bill said. The city would have incurred costs to relocate the gas line because it was in conflict with the sanitary sewer, which is a rated utility. So as a rated utility, the gas company would have the right to charge us for any relocation associated with that.
And they don't move with the same sense of urgency that
they would not be moving at the same sense of urgency as the city. Probably would have stopped the project in its tracks for a little while.
Like I said, I think a nice job in getting this redesigned and keeping it moving along. So thank you.
It was a team effort with everybody.
Okay, I'll go ahead then and make a motion to have legislation prepare approving change order number 1 for the SOM Center Aurora Intersection Improvement Project in the amount of $258,781. No emergency, right?
Okay. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we need it under.
Okay, and to have this done under emergency.
Second.
Motion and a second. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Keturah?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Scherritz?
Yes.
Thanks, Bill.
Thank you.
It's going to take us to item number 8, the authorization to dispose of some city vehicles and equipment that are of no longer municipal use. And with that is going to be Mr. Bandiera. Tom, how are you?
Good. How is everyone tonight?
Good. Thanks.
What I have before the committee tonight is a list of items, vehicles, and equipment that have no further municipal purpose. They're also part of our fleet reduction program in the service department, actually citywide. Some of these vehicles and pieces of equipment are from other departments. We have deemed them to have reached their useful life, so we want to dispose of those to do some fleet reduction, get rid of the items that are costing us a lot of money to maintain. They've served us well, but they need to be disposed of at this time. I would ask that the committee consider to pass this under emergency so we can give the vendor time to come in and appraise these vehicles. I believe most everything on this list is going to be disposed of through Iron Planet. So they'll come in and they'll actually do an appraisal of every piece of equipment, and these could end up anywhere in the world, basically. I think one of our pieces of equipment went over to Germany. So I can answer any questions about this.
Good. Okay. All right, I'd like to make a motion, having legislation prepared to allow the city's finance department to dispose of city vehicles and equipment of no further municipal purpose as per the memorandum from Tom Bandiera, and declare an emergency. Did I do that right?
No, I wanted you to name all of them.
Oh no. If you want me to, I'd be happy to.
And you did it under emergency, right?
Yes, I did.
And I will second that.
So we have a motion.
You guys were taking a bet over there, weren't you?
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmons?
Yes.
Tom, you're still up. We're on item number 9, the renewal of the disposal of solid waste and recycling processing services contract through the Cuyahoga County Solid Waste District Consortium.
That is correct, Mr. Chairman. So what I have before the committee tonight are these two contracts. One is for recycling processing services. The other is a contract that we utilize for the disposal of our solid waste. So we worked with the county back in 2015 to put together a consortium of various different communities to go out to bid to get a better price for our solid waste disposal and also our recycling processing services. It was originally a 3-year contract with an option of 2 1-year renewals. So last year we already enacted the first renewal on that contract, and this would be the second renewal, and then both contracts have to go out to bid. Price is secured for the disposal contract. I believe it is $41.60. So we would stay with Republic, which is right down the street from us in Glen Willow, to dispose of our solid waste. For the recycling processing services, we would stay with Kimball. They're over in Twinsburg, so we take all of our recyclables over there to their dumping center, and that's where they process all the recycling materials. So that particular contract is struggling a little bit right now on their end with the processing fees. So the city pays a processing fee on that contract, but we only pay for the residue. So the residue is the amount of things in the recyclables that shouldn't be in there. It's unfortunately some garbage and items that cannot be recycled end up into the recycling cans in the truck and then end up at the dump station. So they charge us $69 and some change to process those items, because they have to manually be pulled out of the recyclables on a conveyor belt, and then they process anything that is recyclable. So there is no additional fees on that particular contract right now, but moving forward in the future, as I stated in my memo, the whole recycling market is experiencing some pretty bad lows right now. China took about 60% of the U.S.'s raw recycling materials, and they're no longer doing that. So that means the U.S. is kind of stuck with trying to get rid of all these products here in the States. There was a much better market overseas, but the problem with our recyclables are they're so dirty here in the United States, they're tired of processing them over there. So we're going to be making some efforts here in the city to reach out to residents and see what we can do to encourage residents to be conscious about what they put in their recycle carts. And we're going to be doing a mailer to all the residents, just updating some of those products that we would like to see in there, and then the items that we normally see in the recycling carts that we really don't want to see anymore. So this is both contracts are good contracts, securing a price for one more year until September 30th, 2020 on the disposal contract for the solid waste of $41.60. And then also securing the processing contract for the recyclables till September 30th, 2020, with no additional processing fees other than what they're already charging us on the residual. So this was, the recycling contract was a 50-50 revenue share. So as the products were worth some money, they would share profit with the communities that are part of the consortium. When the revenue, or when the processing fee exceeded the revenue, so meaning it cost them more to process the residual than what the products were worth, then we negotiated in our contract that if that would ever happen, thinking we probably would never get to that point, that all the cities would still get 50 cents a ton for those products, which we are currently getting. So we're getting money every month, a small portion, but at least we're not paying. The processing center is claiming that it's costing them close to $96 a ton right now to process those recyclables because the market has taken such a hit and there's no market for glass. And some of the lower plastics, your 4, 5s, and 6, there's no market for it. So we are going to hold them to the contract for one additional year with no additional processing fees, but I can't guarantee what's going to happen in the future. So if this contract, if I get support from the committee tonight to move it on to council, we would have to send a letter of our intent to continue with those two contracts by June 1st. So if we would like to move forward with this, I would need, I really don't need legislation, I just need consent from the committee on this to move forward, just so I can provide the letters to both companies with our intent to, that we're gonna renew. And everybody in the consortium will be doing the same thing.
Sorry, Tom, but it's on the agenda.
Council agenda.
Yeah, I followed what we did with this last year for the 1 year extension, coming to the committee, just getting a consensus from the committee to move this forward. We've thought it would be best to, you know, be transparent with it and just let everybody know what we were doing. We can't just pass, you know, or renew the contract without the Public Works Committee's consensus on this. And maybe Mr. Dursek can add something to it on what we did last year.
It was my understanding that we just got the consensus from the Public Works Committee, and then we forwarded the letter onto both Kimball and Republic for the extension of the contract.
There, I guess the it is on our city council agenda for 7:30 this evening, and so you're saying that we could,
if we
remove that.
We probably could remove it because we already have legislation that authorizes us to participate in this contract originally.
It's clear for the mm-hmm. two additional
yeah.
1 year renewals. Yeah. So, okay. So my concern was
the legislation piece?
Correct.
Okay.
So I am perfectly comfortable moving forward. I appreciate the explanation.
Yes, thank you.
I think we've been also, you know, hearing about some of that in the within the media, that the recyclables are not quite that commodity, that value, that there's not the value associated with the that
they once were,
that there was several years ago. So I think that's something we need to take into consideration going forward, knowing that expenses are going to be going up in that area. As we, you know, later on in this agenda, we're going to be discussing sludge hauling. And I can tell you, in my business, logistically, it's becoming more expensive to get products to me, in all aspects of it. And you're hearing it, and you see these advertisements for commercial truck drivers and things. So I think that we're going to have to, you know, keep that in our mind, that to try to do things to keep as efficient as we can in this, because expenses are probably going to be going up in the next few years. It's Mrs. Meany.
Well, just to comment, I mean, I'm kind of shocked at this. I had no idea that the recycling, that it was at all-time low. I mean, I really, this was...
Yeah, in mid-2018...
I was like, wow, who knew that?
In mid-2018, China decided not to take all of these products anymore. We were shipping everything. 60% of what we recycle in the United States was going overseas, mainly to China. So they're no longer taking those items, and it's getting harder and harder to process them here because we don't have a huge processing center. And so, you know, one of the things I would like to mention is, you know, Kimball, it has a commitment to uphold on this contract when we put it together. They have to recycle those products that all of us are bringing them with that are part of the consortium. And they're doing a good job of it, but they're taking, you know, they're taking a hit on it. And hopefully, you know, I don't know how long a company like that can hold out losing money every single month. So hopefully this starts to rebound and everybody can kind of get on board. The issue is the garbage that's ending up in the recyclables. So as a city, we're going to do some education and reach out to the residents. We have a magnet that's coming in the coming days that we'll be mailing out to all the residents along with a letter from the city. And it'll just be a little bit of a refresher, you know, because times have changed a little bit now. So a lot of the products that are ending up in a recycled container that you wouldn't think of, like food containers, you know, those little tiny cups that you hold dressing and stuff in, those are not recyclable. And when they end up in there with the food waste still in it, it contaminates the mixed paper, contaminates everything. So we're going to try to do some education, do some workshops in conjunction with the county. Our programs, I feel, are just valuable programs. We work very hard to put them in place. Mm-hmm. We've done a lot to keep those items out of the waste stream and save us money, because if not, we're paying for it on the solid waste side.
You bring up a point. How long can a company continue to operate a specific aspect of that business at a loss? And the answer is not in the long term. So obviously they're going to have to increase profits somewhere, and so that's going to probably be, you know, in the future, and if it's affecting them, it's going to be affecting everybody that's in that type of business. So I think we're going to see our costs for disposal increase. So I think we need to try to stay ahead of the curve on that and try to stay as efficient as we can in what we do.
But we have a year to work on it, because this contract will take us a little over a year, till September of 2020.
I mean, with all the, I've been watching the news, different news feeds, and they've been making exactly the same comments with China cutting us off for all the recyclables. I mean, I think we're very benefit, to our benefit, obviously, that we got that extra year out of the contract. We may want to make sure we give the finance department a little heads up for, you know, the next budget, to anticipate something like that, or at least try to get some kind of numbers to, you know, what those companies may have to charge us.
Councilman, even though we're going to move forward and jump on that second renewal, all of the communities in the consortium are going to be working with Diane Bickett and their law director at the county to start putting together a new contract for the future. So those numbers are important, obviously, to every community that's in the consortium, because everyone wants to know what they need to budget for. If there will be a processing fee, it's going to help them determine what they're going to do with their programs too. So we're lucky to be in this contract because it buys us another year where some other communities don't have this protection. So, you know, they may have to pay, you know, immediately to get rid of their recyclables or process them at least. So I appreciate the committee's time and listening to me on this. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for all the details as well. Appreciate it. Brings us to item number 10.
Same thing.
The sludge hauling bid recommendation. I kind of jumped the gun a little bit on that, Paul, but I teed it up for you.
Yes, you did. Nice little segue. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good evening. As we are aware, I think I mentioned to the committee last month that we were going out to advertise for bids for the sludge hauling contract. So on April 26th, we opened bids. As we suspected, we only had one bid from Ohio Bulk. The bids were based on a cost per load of an estimated 280 loads per year. We actually bumped that up. Our original loads that we did back in 2017 was 260 loads, but we've seen a little bit of an increase with our sludge hauling loads this year. So that's why we bumped it up to 280 loads. So Ohio Bulk's bid was $550 a load. This is up about $117.90 from our current cost per load of $432.10. The total estimate for 280 loads per year is going to be about $154,000. I think our estimate for the last 2 years at 260 loads is about $112,000. So we're going to be significantly paying a little bit more money this year for sludge hauling. Obviously, you know, we do our due diligence to contact other companies to find out why we didn't get anyone to participate in bids, and it's virtually the same thing. They could not be competitive with Ohio Bulk's current costs that they're charging us, and they don't have the necessary equipment. So I think you could look at it two ways, you know, that we're getting, yeah, there was only one bid, but it's more reaffirms that we're getting a good price for our hauling bids that we're seeing come in from Ohio Bulk. What I also wanted to point out is, even though the increase went up, as we've had, it's been 4 years since Ohio Bulk's raised their price. So they've maintained $432.10 for the last 4 years without an increase. We contacted Ohio Bulk as well and tried to find out why their costs went up. And to what Councilman Couture alluded to is, you know, hauling costs, the cost of fuels has gone up. They're having problems finding, you know, drivers, qualified drivers for this. So it's forced them to have to pay a little bit more money to try to get qualified drivers. Insurance rates are going up and things of that nature. Also, when we contacted Ohio Bulk, they also offered to maintain their price for 4 years. So in thinking about the economy and thinking about everything that's going on, you know, if we are to accept the bid from Ohio Bulk, it puts us in a good position where they'll maintain that price for another 2 years after the original two-year bid. I discussed this with Tom Loby, the law director, and with Matt Rubino, the finance director, and both thought it was a good deal to try to jump on as well. So if we look at what we actually are requesting, we request a legislation for a two-year contract and accept the base bid from Ohio Bulk in the amount of $550 per load, and we are also requesting an option for 2 1-year contract extensions. So basically, if the end of the two-year contract comes up, we can come to Ohio Bulk and get a mutual agreement that they're okay with moving forward with this. That kind of gives us the option that we can move forward without getting new legislation. I can entertain any question you might have.
Anything from the committee? No. Okay, I'll go ahead then and make a motion to have legislation prepared accepting the bid of Ohio Bulk Transfer Company for our sledge hauling contract for 2 years with an option for 2 1-year contract extensions, and this will be in the amount of $550 per load, and that this be done under emergency.
Second.
We have a motion and a second to proceed to vote.
Mr. Couture?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Schmitz?
Yes.
Thank you.
It's going to take us under correspondence, we have none. Other, we have none. This will bring us to our projects report section. Item number 11, the engineering department study design report. John, it looks like things are picking up in your office.
Yes, they are. If the the committee has my report before them, if you have any questions, I can answer those now.
Any questions from the
I just have a comment. I mean, obviously, when you look under the commercial projects, that's
the
we got a lot going on.
the commercial permitting has been hot and heavy. I cannot lie about that. It's been occupying pretty much all of Jake's time.
Yeah.
But the good news is that our new project engineer Matt Bennett started today. So hopefully, once he gets a little bit more familiar with stuff, he'll be able to start making an impact with all of this stuff. But yeah, the permitting is very, very busy right now.
That's a good thing.
the discount tire, the
it's on Bainbridge Aurora. Is that because it's the street is still in Solon? Is that why it's on this list? Or
We're tracking it as a project because they're as far as how the topography and drainage is, their stormwater from their site is draining into, is discharging into the city's storm sewer system. So they've designed their stormwater management in accordance with the City of Solon's criteria, so they're not discharging it at any greater rate than what it was before. So there should be no impact to our system. But we are, that's why it's on there and why we're tracking it as a project.
Thank you.
Good question. Anything further on item number 11? Okay, seeing none. Item number 12, our construction department report.
Good evening, committee.
Dan, you've been busy too.
Take you right to sheet number 3, the items we usually talk about, emergency road repair. The contract initial value was $378,180. At the end of March, we had $373,660. We used it at one location during the past month, and that was over here at SOM Center, where the storm channel contractor had made a repair to a catch basin, kind of like a practice repair for the SOM Center resurfacing project. That cost us $4,690.99 and leaves us with a balance of $368,969, which appears to be sufficient, and there's other work. Their emergency contractor is continuing to work today. So, although the concrete program is well underway, we haven't performed any real sidewalk work to report yet at this time, but probably by next month I'll have a sidewalk update for that. And so finally, I take you to page number 7, our supplemental inspection services. That for the most part, we've only been using the project at SOM Aurora. The balance as of the end of February was $896,160. We have an invoice for March at $47,561 and estimated the cost for April at $34,166, which leaves us with a balance of $814,432. And I'd be glad to answer any questions that you have.
Nancy?
I just have a quick one. Dan, are you happy with this inspection?
So far, they've been working real hard, doing a really great job for us on the SOM Aurora. Dutiful job, I guess I would say. And I haven't met a lot of the inspectors yet. You know, there's been two people that aren't regulars that have, crossed my path so far. So
okay, good. Good. Glad to hear that.
And I do like the report. I appreciate the proposed start dates that you have. And, you have the proposed, the actual, and proposed finish. I think that's very helpful to us to have that kind of information when residents call. We can at least give them the idea of what the the original plan was. So thank you.
You're welcome.
Anything further? Item 12. Okay, it takes item number 13, the 2019 annual sanitary and storm system repair program update. Mike?
Before the committee, you see the list of all the jobs pending for tracks construction. With everything paid off, when the jobs are completed, it'll be $85,986.06. There was one job pending at White Oak. We'll be doing some creek restoration. I've not received an estimate for that yet. So that would bring the total of the contract to $364,013.94. I can answer any questions.
Put a dent into it.
We're trying.
It takes us to item number 14, the Water Reclamation Department report. Paul, it seems like we're still seeing some heavy flows down there.
Yes. Actually, with the most recent rain events, we've had the chance to utilize our new equalization tank quite a bit here. So it's been a blessing on more aspects than just the storm flow. We've actually used it for some of our process control, as I mentioned last time, with this hydraulic flow coming in from the storm events. We've had a lot of settling issues here in the springtime, and it's definitely helped us out significantly to be able to use those tanks. So again, another added benefit of the equalization system. I wanted to report on the change order log attached to the back of my report. This is for contract A. This is with AP O'Hara, the general contractor. If we look on the back of that sheet, we'll see on 4-8 the latest change order that have come to the table. Item number 30 was revisions to grading supports. This is an area at the new pump station where the engineer did not have a actual grading over this area that operators would have to frequently be at when they're operating the pump station or cleaning out the actual pump station area. We needed to put some extra supports in order to get that grading in. It was reviewed by the engineer as all the costs were in line. That came out to $9,991.80. We approved that on 4-8. We also asked them for an estimate to paint the interior of the screen building, as that was not included in the cost of the project. The amount of $20,625 just was too expensive in my eyes to cover that painting, so we're going to attempt to do that in-house and take care of that. So that leaves the estimated balance. This is our contingency money. It will have $185,987.17 remaining. I think there's a couple more smaller change orders that are going to come up as far as this month, and I'll keep you informed of that as of next meeting. Also, I wanted to bring to the committee's attention that the time extension, the no-cost time extension that we originally proposed back in February, is going to come to a close here on May 10th. The contractor is going to have 99% of their work completed. The only thing that we're not going to have completed is our pinch valve. There's been some problems with the pinch valve as far as the design. The contractor was working with the manufacturer to try to come up with something that would work to the intentions of the original design specifications, and they could not come up with an agreement. So virtually the contractor has had to go with a whole new manufacturer, and this is going to delay. We're actually waiting for a time frame that he can give us, which is going to be a delay. So I will be coming back to the committee for another no-cost time delay. And this is just due to the way our contract language is written, is that we have to have completion before we can close out the contract. So in order for us to meet the letter of the law, the way the contract's written, I'm going to need another contract extension for that. So once I get the time frame from the contractor of where he thinks that delivery date and installation date is going to be, then I'll come back to the committee with another no-cost time extension. But from what I've been told, it's going to be at least 10 to 14 weeks. So other than that, everything is on track to close out.
Great.
Anything further? That will take us to item number 15. Tom, you have 6 minutes for your service department report, if you need it.
Is there any questions from the committee?
Anything you want to point out?
Just that we're very busy right now and trying to get a lot of stuff done. So if you get calls from your residents about brush, you can assure them that we have, today we had 5 crews out plus the crane truck, and we plan on trying to keep that going as long as we can. We're a little short on resources, but we're trying to hit that very hard. It's just a bad time of the year. We get bombed with the brush from the pickup in the yard, so we're trying to get it collected as quickly as possible. And I would like to make one comment that tomorrow, 2 of our employees in the service department are having a 40-year anniversary with the city.
Are those?
Who's that?
Jim and John Thompson.
Jim and John, yeah. Oh, definitely. That would have been my, wow, 40 years.
Congratulations to them. Good
thing. Please tell them congrats.
It's impressive. Impressive. Hmm. Engineer Bush.
One thing I wanted to update the committee on that is an update to my report is we did receive our federal authorization for the summer surfacing project, and it will advertise for the first time on Thursday, May 9th. It is an extended bidding period because it's an ODOT required, that's an ODOT requirement of the federal guidelines. So tentatively right now, the project will open on May 31st. That is an update to my report. Thank you.
How much of an extension is that from what we would normally do?
It's a additional week. Additional week.
Great. Let's say we had a very good meeting. Thank you, everybody. Thanks, Mayor. Appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.
And I will entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll make that motion to adjourn.
Second it.
We have a motion and a second to adjourn. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Shimmets?
Yes.